Convergence of Indian Accounting Standards with IFRS. You say recently, we know I have little knowledge in the area of accounting standards because basically I am familiar with finance, theory of finance. The last 28 years I have been teaching only finance area, financial management and international financial management, but by Mr. Payaman, who has chosen this particular standards, IFRS. I have shown some interest as a learner rather than a teacher in this particular topic. So with regard to my convergency, it seems that the word to harmonize and maintain uniformity with IFRS. So convergency means sales and maintaining some uniformity and also making coordination between the Indian accounting standards and international accounting standards. Basically, you know, well, as far as intellectual part is concerned, IFRS is a set of high quality, understandable, enforceable, and globally accepted principle based accounting standards for preparation of financial statements. As you all know, all the business enterprises and multinational companies, they are supposed to prepare the accounting information through by preparing all the financial statements. Here, International Accounting Financial Standards Board is there, IASB, International Accounting Standards Board. It's an independent body, setting by body of the IFRS Foundation. So the origin of this IFRS is IASB, International Accounting Standards Board. And it is responsible for development and publication of IFRS by following a thorough, open and transparent review process in close consultation with the stakeholders around the world. As far as IASB was set up in 2001, International Accounting Standards Board was set in 2001 to replace the former standard setting body, IASC, International Accounting Standards Committee. That means earlier there is a IASC that was replaced with IASB. That is the use of IFRS, it's a financial reporting language, is gaining momentum across the world. You know, well, as a part of liberalization and globalization, it's an inevitable situation for introduction of IFRS, because all the countries, more majority of the countries in the world, are following the practices of accounting information through IFRS. More than 100 countries such as Australia, European Union, Russia, now required to allow our use of having decided to adopt IFRS, and the number is expected to increase further in the coming years. But there are two alternatives with regard to comply with the IFRS to available to the countries in two ways. One is adoption of IFRS in its original form as it is. The second alternative is adoption or convergence with IFRS, keeping in view of the advantages of implementing IFRS for the Indian economy, investors, industry, accounting profession and accounting standards board. Because you know, well, we are following the standards fixed by the ASB, accounting standards board, according to the internal environment of our country, investors, keeping in view of the Indian economy and the industry and accounting profession, that we are adopting certain information from IFRS, which is convenient according to the internal environment of the country. See, The Council of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, the Indian Council of Accountant of Institute of Chartered Accountants, ICA, decided to follow convergence path. Because in our country, the recommendations made by the ICAI is that we have to follow the second option, second alternative, convergence path. In general, you know, well, say this convergence is maintaining, harmonizing and maintaining the uniformly with IFRS. See, the IASB Indian International Accounting Standards Board clarifies adding disclosure requirements or removing optional requirements as per the local environment at conditions that does not lead to non-compliance with IFRS. That in Indian context, convergence with IFRS means adoption of IFRS with necessary modifications to reflect the Indian conditions as far as adoption is concerned. Convergence means adoption. To what extent that we are IFRS we are following? Because it is the internal environment of the country and recommended by ICAI. So based on that, that we are not following all the IFRS standards, but what is convenient, which is more convenient, which is suitable to the Indian conditions that we are adopting. So as accounting standards in India, current status, that in India accounting standards are formulated by the Council of ICAI through Accounting Standards Board, and which was formed in the year 1977. The National Advisory Committee on Accounting Standards, NACAS, constituted under Section 210 of through Companies Act Amendment Act 1999, reviews those standards and recommends them to the central government. The government then considers the recommendations of the NACAS and on accepting they notifies the standards under the Indian Companies Act 1956 by publishing them in the official gazette. Initially, the accounting standards were only recommendary in nature, but after intersection of Section 211(3)(c), subsection 3(c), by the Companies Amendment Act 1999, compliance with notified accounting standards has been mandatory. At present, 31 accounting standards have been issued by the ICAI, out of which 28 standards are said to be mandatory, but with 3 standards are not mandatory. So, in 2007, the ASB Accounting Standards Board finalized the concept paper on convergence with IFRS in India after considering the suggestions of the Council of ICAI and commenced the process of developing a complete new set of accounting standards that are based on and convergent with IFRS, referred to as the Indian Accounting Standards (IND-AS). The IND-AS are allowed to depart from IFRS to account for the differential cultural, legal, political, economic environments as part of convergence strategy. ICAI has classified IFRS in the following categories. See, ICAI classified IFRS into category 1, category 2, category 3, category 4. In category 1, IFRS, which can be adopted immediately or in the near future, as there are no or minor differences with corresponding Indian accounting standards. For example, conception, contracts, borrowing costs, inventories, cash flow statements. As far as this category 1 is concerned, there won't be much difference between Indian accounting standards and IFRS. So that will be adopted immediately without any further hesitation. Category 2 is concerned IFRS, which may require some time to reach a level of technical preparedness by the industry and professionals, keeping in view the existing economic environment and other factors. For example, investment property, shared basic payment, these are the second category which needs some sort of preparedness to implement these standards in Indian conditions. Category 3 is concerned IFRS having conceptual differences with corresponding Indian accounting standards that should be discussed with the IASB. So the third category of standards IFRS is need to be discussed thoroughly, and with particularly third category is investments in associates, joint ventures, provisions and contingency liabilities. These are the four important items that need to be discussed by implementing Indian conditions, because it is only IASB that has to recommend how best we can prepare these standards and submit the information. The category 4 is concerned IFRS, the adoption of which would require amendments in the laws and regulations, because this category of standards which we have to implement in Indian conditions, IFRS standards, needs some amendments in the laws, because you need to make some amendments or changes in the law or enactment of the or something, laws and regulations with regard to policies, accounting policies, property, plant and equipment, first time adoption of IFRS. The fourth category is concerned that needs some amendment in the laws and regulations. So all these four categories clearly say that with regard to adoption of IFRS in the Indian conditions, IAS, what best that we can do, the four categories have been classified like this. And in pursuance of the commitment given by Indian G20 Summit held in Petersburg in September 2009, 35 Indian accounting standards converged with the IFRS were notified by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, MCA, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, and placed on the website of MCA in February 2011. The Indian accounting standards were supposed to came into force 1st April 2011. However, the implementation of these standards got postponed for various reasons. The Ministry of Corporate Accounting, that is MCA, recently notified the companies Indian Accounting Standards Rules 2015 on February 16, that is the latest information about IFRS that is announced by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. And the recent developments in India to achieve convergence. What is it that we have converted this IFRS standards into India? The recent information is, in a move to converge with the IFRS, that the provisions have been incorporated in the New Companies Act 2013, that is, which came into force in September 2013. As per section 129, subsection 3 of the Act, mandates the consolidated financial statements for any company having a subsidiary or associate or a joint venture. It's a mandatory, compulsory. From 2013 onwards, the companies which are going to prepare the financial statements, consolidated financial statements pertaining to subsidiary or associate or joint venture, it's a mandatory. And the Act has also given cognizance to the IFRS, Indian Accounting Standards converging with IFRS, considering their applicability in future also. For instance, statement of changes in equity required under Indian accounting standards has been included in the definition of accounting financial statements under the new Act. That is, new Act also provides for valuation of registered values to facilitate computation of fair value. Moreover, MCA, Ministry of Company Affairs, has notified and made applicable revised Schedule 6 from 1st April 2011. It is compatible with IFRS and only allows the presentation of balance sheet and profit and loss account in vertical format and eliminates the option of horizontal format. So some modification is presentation is formal, vertical and eliminating margin. That is, grouping of assets and liabilities has been made as a correct and non-correct, and furthermore, Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, by circular dated 2010 April 10 has given an option to listed entities having subsidiaries to prepare their consolidated financial statements either in conformity with the existing accounting standards notified under Companies Act 1956 or IFRS issued by IASB. However, only a few companies have exercised the IFRS option. In the budget speech 2014 and 15, the Honorable Minister, the late, because the Arun Jaitley is no more now, is late Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said that the convergent Indian accounting standards will become mandatory from fiscal year 2016 and 17. So, current previous year, that however they can be adopted by companies on voluntary basis from fiscal year 2015-16. The announcement is in line with the ICAI proposal roadmap. It is envisaged that this move would improve the quality of financial reporting in India and would attract foreign capital into the country. So the main motto by announcing the finance minister, Arun Jaitley, late finance minister, is just to make some transparency in the accounts and attracting the foreign firms from outside the country. For that purpose, Jaitley has clearly stated in the parliament that the announcing that all the companies must be follow the IFRS standards is a mandatory from 2013 onwards. And the roadmap for implementation of IFRS in India, I read out. On 22nd January 2010, 31st March 2010, MCA has issued a press release laying down the roadmap for IFRS convergence in India. The roadmap requires convergent Indian accounting standards by a AASB to be applied in a basic manner by insurance companies, other companies, the various phases and respective timelines for convergence have been shown. You see, as per the statement given by the MCG, that is, there are three categories of the companies which are mandatory for listing out the listed companies, unlisted companies, group companies, A, B, C. All these listed companies will have to come under phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4. In phase 1, financial year 2016 and 17, the listed companies, all the companies listed are in the process of being listed with net worth of INR 500 crores, more than 500 crores. By converting this US dollars, it is 72 million US dollars. So any company which is more than 500 crores net worth, that they have to follow in a phased manner conversion of this accounting standards into IFRS from 2016-17 financial year in phase 1. By moving to phase 2, that is in 17 and 18, all the companies listed are in the process of being listed, not covered under phase 1. Whatever the companies that are not covered in the phase 1, that will come under phase 2, that is in 2017-18. And the next thing is the unlisted companies. All the companies with the net worth about more than 500 crores, that these unlisted companies also will come under this category. Okay. Phase 3, companies having a net worth of INR more than 250 crores are US dollars, 26 million dollars, that will come under phase 2. And group companies applicable to holding, subsidiaries, joint ventures, and associates of companies covered under A and B. Likewise, the mandatory that was made by phase manner from 2016-17, 17-18, 18-19, and 19-20, these three categories of companies, listed companies, unlisted companies, and group companies will come under a phased manner to follow these standards about IFRS. You know this IFRS benefits by adopting this IFRS, what is called as accounting standards. Convergence with IFRS gives here, increases the transparency, improves the level of understandability, comparability between the financial statements, companies across the different countries, from one country to another country, will make a comparison between two countries, how the preparators of this accounting information through by adopting the IFRS, and better market efficiency, and also increased capital formation, greater economic growth of India, financial capital flows to India, and better lower cost of the funds from abroad, more international business collaborations and joint ventures, reduces standard settings of the cost of India, more relevant, reliable, capable, timely, truly, fair and comparable accounting information to investors and other stakeholders, and difficult for companies to commit accounting frauds like Heron and Steya. These are not so easy to commit frauds by adopting this IFRS. The main aim objective behind this IFRS adoption is to eliminate frauds, commitment of frauds, as again was done at the international level and the national level. So, more opportunities for greater mobility of Indian accounting and IT professionals to work in different parts of the country, India can emerge as a major hub for offering accounting and IT services. So, there are having some merits and demerits, but demerits will overcome these merits because demerits are there, lack of detailed guidance, limited guidance for the IFRS standards, etc., etc. So, I hope so that this particular information, what I have given, adoption, convergence, may be useful for you, for my students and participants. Thank you for giving this opportunity to our. Thank you very much.